feels so good to be back in the largest city in Nigeria. I mean, this city alone is the most populous city in the entire Africa, not just Nigeria. But hey, wherever you see, ha! Come on, I'm doing an intro. Where, ha! Ha, that's the Yoruba demon. Don't worry, I'm doing an intro. Let me finish.
When did you come to Lagos?
I'm in Lagos, bro. Hold on, let me finish my video. I don't even know what I'm saying. Tayo, jeez. Hey, I'll still educate you. Don't worry. Lagos is the major financial center of the entire Africa, man. Did you know that?
Yes. You're asking me if I know that. That's my city, bro.
I'm in your city.
Let me show you around.
You want to show me around?
There's a very big estate that has many of the biggest celebrities in Nigeria.
I only talk about estate that are owned by Africans.
Yeah, it's owned by an African.
Are you sure about that?
Owned by one African.
One African, one not African. Even two.
No, just one.
See, Tayo wants to take me around and you all have to come with me. Let me go see this estate that the dopest vlogger is talking about. If you don't know him, which means you live under a rock, he's one of the dopest vlogger in the entire Nigeria, not just Lagos. Hey, do you know my name?
Ndibo.
In the Igbo? No, I'm an Hausa man with an Igbo chieftaincy title. So my name is Ichie Issa Wanne Dinamba. Come, let me go show you the estate that the dopest vlogger is talking about. Let's go.
So yeah, wear your seatbelts. Let me take you. I'm taking you somewhere. Lagos, Ghana man, Mr. Biggest YouTuber in Africa. Let me show you what is happening in Lagos.
In Lagos,
so many things are happening.
You're a Lagos vlogger now.
Yeah,
I am. The dopest vlogger, always flying your drones around, showing us how beautiful Lagos is.
Yeah.
Man, the property you're going to show me,
yeah.
You're the owner.
Am I the owner?
Yeah.
Not yet, but I'm buying mine soon. Just like the African man I'm going to show you. The Nigerian man who owns the property.
Who owns the property?
Yeah, I'm going to show you a really nice estate here. Yeah.
Tell us one thing that you think people don't know about Lagos.
So I think Lagos has some of the most expensive real estates in Africa. Mm. Some of the most expensive real estate properties in Africa is in Lagos. You can find them in Lagos.
Whoa.
Yeah. So I want to show you, I'm taking you to the estate now.
You said the people that live there are celebrities or
something? Yes, so many celebrities. All the celebrities you watch on TV, many of them that do all these music videos, all of them are here.
Then I need to also get a house there now.
Yeah, you need to, because you are a YouTube celebrity. Hey, yes. See your chain.
I'm a chief celebrity.
Yeah, you are a chief celebrity from all the tribes in Nigeria.
You want Kwenu.
Kwenu.
And you want Kagani.
All of Yoruba. Yoruba one.
Yoruba. Kilo
Shele. Kilo De.
Bawone. Kilo De.
Okay, so now we are at the gates.
Okay.
We are driving. See how massive the estate is.
Nice.
Big estate. Security everywhere. You can see one of the signboards, Fowls. This is Fowls' lane.
Fowls' lane?
Yeah,
Fowls. He's a celebrity.
Yeah, he's a celebrity.
He has his own lane in
there. Yeah, he has his own lane.
That's impressive.
Just check out. See how massive this place is. Just check it out. See. All this owned by one person. Yeah. Here we are, man. Just check out this estate.
Nigerians love big things.
No, we love everything big. It has to be massive. We like it big, massive, expensive, luxurious. No, I didn't say that one. I just said houses.
You love everything big now.
Yeah, everything big and, you know, big. You feel me?
You see the castle here.
Yeah, everything is. Yeah.
Nigerians love everything expensive and big.
Yeah, that's how we roll. Why are you bouncing like that?
No, I'm not a Nigerian,
okay,
bro.
Okay, and you're also a chief, Abi. I'm going to be linking you up with my friend.
Okay.
And then she's going to take us on a tour around this. You're going to meet her soon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, here she is.
Hi.
Oh, yeah. You're Tayo's friend, eh?
Yes, I am.
Wow, you're a young billionaire. He has been telling me that you own this whole estate.
Well, my name is Ifuma Ilesanmi. Okay. I don't own this estate, but Mr. Tayo Shonuga, the CEO of Haven Homes, owns this estate.
You are not the
CEO. He's a developer of the estate.
Which means you are not the CEO.
No, I'm not the CEO.
You know, this is what I've been saying, that it's not good to have friends like Tayo. They will lie to you before you get your location.
But I mean, you need to get to know the CEO. He's really? A fantastic man. I mean, as you can see, I'm the GM of Haven Homes, a young GM, a girl, you know. So, I mean, you should get to meet him soon.
And his name is Tayo too.
His name is Tayo. Is the name really Tayo?
Yes, the name is Tayo. You have to confirm that.
Yeah, confirm. So you are the general manager?
Yes, I am.
Of Haven Homes?
Yes, I am.
That's impressive.
Thank you.
You're so young.
Yes, I am. I am. Wow. So that's the thing about Mr. Tayo Shunuga. I've known him for 10 years.
Okay.
And what he does is that he basically just gets young individuals like myself, grows us, and, you know, become who we are today.
He believes
so much in the youth. Yes. And then he doesn't even, there's no difference between a male or a female. And you know, my industry, the men dominate my industry.
That's true.
But, you know, I'm the GM, just after him.
Now you really want me to know more about him. You know, like, what I want to know is, was he born and raised in Nigeria?
He was born and raised in Nigeria. Wow. You know,
Ty was telling me that he left to the UK.
Yeah, he did leave to the UK, but came back to Nigeria to set up this company, and he's been doing it for 15 years. And he's just so passionate about, you know, Nigeria, growing Nigeria economy, growing, just seeing young people, you've seen people developing properties. It just is something that, you know.
You know, I've been telling so many Africans that it's time to be part of the solution, not the problems. Do you know the people that complains more about Nigeria? It's Nigerians.
Yes. I agree.
Nigerians complain so negatively about Nigeria.
I agree.
Nigerians that are doing fantastic in Nigeria.
Yeah.
Change that mindset now and be part of that change. Our fatherland must develop, mm-hmm. and you have to be part.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, agreed.
Yeah, I'm now in Nigeria.
Amen.
We can see that.
Amen.
We can see that. We are chief turns to title.
I just want to know, how many houses has he built so far?
We've built over 400 houses or more. So, but on top of my head now, 400.
400
more.
Houses.
Yeah, and we still have about 200 in the works. Right now.
That's over 600.
Yes.
15 years ago, mm-hmm. to now. Man is a visionary, man.
It definitely is.
Is there anything that you think we need to know about where we are right now?
We are at Richmond Gate Estate 2 and 3.
Okay.
And this is where we have a variety of properties. 2-bed, mezzanette, 3-bed, 4-bedroom, townhomes, mezzanettes, and 5-bedroom quadplets. I mean, different varieties of properties as you can see in estates. And that's the unique thing about Haven Homes. Like,
wow.
we the visionary is constantly thinking about new things, which is Mr. Tayo Shunuga. What else we can do, what's new. This is a townhome, for example.
Okay.
I mean, it's different from, you know, any other thing. You won't see this anywhere because it's like 3-4 floors.
Okay.
It's very interesting design. So that's the thing about it. It's just always thinking about something different. Every project is something unique, something different. Yeah.
And as I can see, like, even going around Lagos, I think the designs here are actually pretty unique in their own.
Yes. That's a lot of people think more about the external. Oh, the external looks good. But you know, one part that people never really talk about is actually the internal.
Mm.
The internal is literally crafted in different ways and different unique style. So
is it, there's something that you just told me, the owner being an African.
Yeah.
But sometimes, you know, like everything in Africa, people believe that it doesn't owned by an African,
yeah?
But now you've confirmed that the owner is an African. But I just want to know, the people who built this whole property, are they Africans?
Africans, built by Nigerians from the beginning till now.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
And you know one thing that is even more interesting? The owner of the company has never taken a loan from any bank anywhere. It's just been growing and growing for the past 15 years, nonstop.
Wow. So you said he has built over 600 houses, right?
Yes, 200 in works.
Okay, 200 is being constructed.
Yes.
So where did this all start from?
Started in Magodo, mainland,
okay.
Lagos, but on an island, just around here.
Interesting. I can see you guys have bikes here.
Yes, this is a bike for the estate. These are very interesting because we basically live very green in this estate. So if you want to just ride to your house, instead of walking down, you can just pick a bike, drop it back and put it back here when you come back.
That's interesting. So Mr. Asaya is concerned about the environment.
Absolutely.
It feels like I'm still in China, man. I used to steal one of these bikes and put it in my room.
I'm going to send your name to you right now.
I'm sorry.
So I second that.
So what about this place? Where are we currently now?
So this building is actually called Alma One.
Okay.
This is one I'm talking about, the first building on the island. One of the first ones on the island. So it's constructed about 18 units, 18 all the way units. Down to the stretch. Okay. Yeah.
You mean the first ever project that he built here on the island?
Well, one of. Because there were one still other top. Ones within the, but not an estate.
Very plenty.
Yes.
I can't wait to meet this guy. I mean, let me not say guy. Maybe it could be a man.
I'll allow you watch and see. Maya, did I tell you I lived in the UK?
You lived in the UK?
Yes, for a short while. Maybe about 2 years.
2 years.
You know, one question that always comes up, how is Africa? How is Africa? This is Africa.
This is Africa, indeed.
Yeah.
I mean, how many people own this house?
One person.
Just one person?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, in the UK, everyone tries to get mortgage money, but this is not mortgage, this is cash. One person.
Paid in full.
He's been living here for almost 3-4 years. Yeah.
If I tell people that Africa is luxury, they don't understand.
They absolutely don't.
You own this house in the UK.
It's going to be very difficult.
You can't. It's going to be very difficult, especially in London. It's very difficult.
People should come back to Nigeria.
Thank you. Why did you come back to Africa, by the way?
Well, work and development. For me, real estate is like one deep passion. Coming back to build and make people feel happy is absolutely mind-blowing
for
me.
But why you didn't become a real estate developer in the UK?
In the UK.
Do you know how long it takes to get to where I am here in Africa? The way I've gotten to in Africa here, you know, definitely takes a long
time. We have more African young women that look like you that are living in the UK, and they were like, I'm not coming back home. If you have a message for them, what will you say?
Better come back home, because here is life.
Interesting. I've seen something interesting in here.
Really?
And someone coming from Ghana, seeing to a savage street in here. I mean, it looks a little bit like weird. I mean, who are the people that lives in here? Yeah. Because I'm seeing to a savage street. You saw it too?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, okay. I'm even seeing Kiss Daniel Street. I'm like, what is going on in here?
I mean, everyone knows that they live here. I mean, it's...
So let me understand. They live here, so they have their own streets.
Mm-hmm.
Hi.
Although, there are other high net worth individuals who live here as well, who really like their privacy. I mean, for every one of them, there are tons and tons of other people
that
are here.
But do you know that I'm a celebrity?
Yeah.
I'm buying a house in here today.
Oh, yes.
Hold on.
With your Maya seat.
Let me know, how much does it cost to afford a home in here?
So it ranges from about, it depends on what you're buying, 2-bedroom, from 50-something to about 100 and something million.
100 and something million. I'll buy the one with 100 and something million, okay? Because I want my name to be on the street in here.
Then I'll move inside with you. You give me my own room. No, you're
I need Wedemeyer Street in here.
We have to make that work, Wedemeyer Street.
Fantastic. And every one of you should come in here, take photos. I mean, I would love to own a house in here. Mm-hmm. I mean, this looks beautiful, Ty. You don't think so?
It does. It really does. It really looks very,
thank
very
you.
Beautiful.
Man, and I like the fact that it's owned by an African, and I would love to have one-on-one chats with him.
Absolutely.
You see, it seems like you don't want to tell me the people that lives in here. Fine. But there should be that celebrity friend. Since Tayo is your friend, there should be that celebrity friend that you would love me to go to his home.
You know what?
And show me around.
I'm going to take you to one's property.
Really?
Thank you.
Yes, okay, I am.
So what makes Haven Homes unique?
Haven Homes is unique because of our architecture, the outside and both the inside. If you see from outside, you'd be like, oh wow, people wonder if this is Africa when they see it.
Really?
And then when you go inside, people also wonder, wow, like every single unit is different and designed in different ways. So it's pretty much that. And then also the way we've done personalized systems that allows us to watch the quality of everything from scratch to finish, that gives it also quite unique feel when you enter the property or when you live in the property.
But Tayo, I mean, you've been doing more of real estate videos here in Nigeria. So far, what you've seen so far, what do you think of it?
What do I think of this place?
Exactly.
I think it's really, really beautiful. I think I love the designs of the houses. Each one, they all look unique from each other.
Mm-hmm.
And it's also different from most of what I've seen in other real estate estates.
Wow. For me, I think this is really massive.
Yeah, it is.
And you know what I always celebrate? I celebrate Africa.
Doing amazing stuff.
That is me. Yeah, you know, I don't care how it looks like, but the fact that it's owned by an African, yeah. I would say I love it. Yeah. But, you know, this estate also looks world class, to be honest. You know, I'm seeing trees in here.
Yeah,
because, you know,
yeah,
some of the estates, you go there, it's like blocks.
Yeah, blocks.
But here you see trees. I mean, even the recreational centers that I've seen so far, you can play soccer in here,
you
volleyball.
Swim.
Yeah,
I'm a best swim.
I know you like swimming.
Yeah, I like swimming. When you come here, I'm going to teach you how to swim. But hey, I hope you guys enjoyed this amazing video. And you know what? My brother Tayo is also a YouTuber. He's the dopest vlogger that you'll ever find here in Nigeria. So hey, do me a favor, go to his YouTube channel and go and subscribe.
Yeah, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and let's get to 200,000 subscribers this month. And also, with Maya, we need 40k.
We need 40k more.
40k
so
more.
What are you waiting for? Don't be stingy.
It's free.
Ah, thank you. Tell them. It's free to subscribe.
Hit the bell icon for all notifications.
We forgot our beautiful GM. She's not a YouTuber, but unfortunately she's married. I'm giving her to you guys, but hey, you know what? Say something nice to her. GM, any message for Africans watching us right now?
Africans watching, make sure you come back home, see the beautiful things that Africans are doing. Come back, you never know, you might be the next one to do the next big thing.
Whoa, no, your message for Nigerians in Nigeria.
Nigerians in Nigeria, you actually don't know what's going on in Nigeria. So you need to see, look around, and do the best things that you can do. You never know. You also might be the next big thing.
Thank you so much for watching, and we're gonna see you in the next one.